Loads. Thank you. It's nice pinging around like a game of pong. Hello everyone, my name's Yianni. If anyone's wondering where my accent comes from, I come from an island off the west coast of New Zealand. It's called Australia. And now you're probably going, Yianni's not an Australian name, but wrong, it's an Aboriginal name, and it means white man. Whose parents moved from Cyprus. So that's how you get this combination, right? You get the accent, and that's from Australia, but the arm hair. That is from Cyprus. As is the palm hair, eyeball and tooth hair. Because we're hairy fuckers in Cyprus, which is not a problem if you are an adult. Male. But when you are my sister. Or me as a 9-year-old boy. It's not good, because when you are 9 and hairy, which is a Channel 5 documentary. Just realise there are people in from Channel 5. And it's quality programming, you should all tune in. Still got the other three. Still got the other three channels, so let's try not to ostracise the rest. When you are 9 and hairy, kids at your school do stuff to you to make your life absolute hell. Like, when I was 9 and hairy, there was this kid at my school who, to make me look stupid, shaved off one of my eyebrows. Don't worry about me, joke was on him, I only had one. Yeah, did not look stupid, no. Looked shocked. No, but you know, if you're hairy, you're hairy, you should just accept that, right? You know, it's just your genes. Everyone in this room looks different because we've all got different genes, right? For example, I'm hairy, that's my genetics. I'm also colorblind, that's my genetics too, right? Colorblindness is actually a genetic condition, it's quite common amongst men, although you will notice it quite unusually for a black man, I am ginger. Yeah, it's good to see so many brothers in. Wearing that joke, isn't it? Sometimes you do that joke and white people kind of go, but there's none in. Yeah, people say weird shit to you when they find out that you're colorblind. Like, my mate Rich found out that I was colorblind. He was like, I see, you know, he said, but you're colorblind. And I was like, yeah. And he goes, how do you drive a car? How do you deal with traffic lights? And I was like, oh. Actually, Rich, that is a really good question, and it's quite complicated. Okay, so sit down, and I'll explain it to you. Okay. So basically, what I do is that I know that the top one, the top one, that is usually the red one, and the bottom one. 99 times out of 99 is the green one, right? And I could just see in his face, he was so grateful that I'd explained it to him. And he was like, all right, smart ass. Yeah, but the red one doesn't look red to you. No, it doesn't. And I was like, no. And he said, the green one doesn't look green to you. Does it? And I was like, no. He said, well, what color does the red one look? I said, the red one looks kind of yellow. He said, what color does the green one look? I said, the green one looks kind of white. Which flipped him the fuck out, because there is only one country where white means go, Zimbabwe. You see, it wasn't a joke about traffic lights at all, it was a joke about politics. In some rooms where that joke doesn't do very well, but we are a predominantly black crowd. See, I don't understand the sort of consternation at that sort of reference, right? Because see, people are very racially sensitive here. I don't understand that, because I come from Australia and we don't have racism there. Of course we've got racism in Australia. We have it in all forms. We have race riots in Sydney. Race riots in Sydney. In Australia. With Australians. What the fuck do you even say? As an Australian race rider, what do you say? Why don't you fuck off home, mate? You were here third. Yeah. I didn't always do this job. Before I did this job, I used to be a lawyer. That's what I did. Yeah, I used to be a lawyer, right? So I studied law at university. That's a little bit dry and boring, right? So I spruced it up with finance. Yeah, law and finance, right? Now, I've got a question for me. What the fuck was I thinking? What was going through my stupid head when I was 17 years old? I was half training to be a lawyer and half training to be a banker. It's like when I was 17 years old, someone went to me, "What do you want to be when you grow up, Yianni?" And I was like, "An all-round mega cunt!" That was a puppy! I dropped the C-bomb and killed a dog. All of a sudden, the Channel 5 guy's back on! No, man. I studied finance. I'm a Cypriot who studied finance. People are kind of like, "Oh, your country could have used you." Oh, man. We were so happy when Greece was fucked. We were like, and that is why you should never make fun of your cousins. Seriously, the Greek finance minister had to go in front of the European Parliament and ask for 250 billion euros. And you thought this was a tough gig. I saw it on TV. It was amazing. Like, he walked in. He was kind of like this. He walked in. He had to go. "Hello, everybody. You're all looking very well. Oh, Hungary, is that a new dress? Oh, Germany, have you lost weight? Now, we're going to need 650 billion euros now. Allow me to explain what has happened. We have borrowed too much money from you all and spent it all." "So now you all must give us more money to spend now, or all of your economies are going to die." It's not blackmail, it's called economic codependence. It's like emotional codependence, but without the filthy sex. Now, many of you are now thinking, why should we pay Greece this money? But what you have to understand is that Greece, we are the inventors of many useful things that you use every day. Things like democracy, mathematics, and the buggery of small boys. And the majority of you who are not the Channel 5 are now thinking, that is a bit inappropriate. However, we're also hoping to secure funding from Vatican City! And they're not exactly going to pay us for science. Let's face facts, because they don't. No, man. Many of you probably are going, "Oh, Yianni, you're a Cypriot and you studied law and now you're a comedian. How'd your family react to that?" Well, to be honest with you, they didn't mind because my family didn't want me to be a lawyer or a comedian. Yeah, my yaya, that's my grandmother, she wanted me to be a priest. She was like, "Yianni, you should be a priest, right? Because everyone would love you. It would be amazing." And I was like, I'm not going to be a priest for two main reasons. Like, one, because I don't believe it, and I'm pretty sure that's a prerequisite. And two, because I'm a stand-up comedian, and I pretty much do the same job. I stand in front of a room full of people seeking escape from reality, telling stories that probably aren't 100% true. But at least I write my own stuff. Thanks very much, everyone.